Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrolaguy, with another in the series. There is a lot of misinformation on the internet about lead content in Edison dictation cylinders. These EDIPHONE cylinders, the Columbia cylinders, a lot of people, for some reason, I have no idea why, are putting out a lot of bad information that these blanks contain lead, and if you shave them, you're going to die. Now, Edison produced these blanks for over 70 years to be shaved every day in office buildings, and it just didn't seem probable to me that something that was going to be used every day by the public for 70 years contained lead. So I contacted a testing laboratory. I use a lot of these blanks, and I wanted to make sure, just to satisfy myself, that there was no lead in them. So I contacted a testing laboratory, and they put me on to 3M lead check swabs. This is what they use. Red means lead. Instant lead test. This will test for any kind of lead on anything, whether it's surface, whether it's molecular, whether it's paint, whether it's powder, whether it's dust. If there's lead present, this will detect it. And it's a really simple test, and basically it's just a couple of plastic swabs with two different chemicals in them, and you break these, mix it together. You apply this to the surface for 30 seconds. If it turns red, it contains lead. If it doesn't, it doesn't. It's simple as that. So, just to satisfy myself, we are going to test one of these voice writing blanks that I have modified into a recording blank. You see this one is broken, so nothing lost in testing this. And you can also see that it is indeed an EDIPHONE blank with the cloth core. So, what I'm going to do is scrape the surface of the cylinder just to make sure we get a nice, fair test here. Alright, so now we have some fresh swarf and we have a nice, fresh surface that I have just scraped for this test. So, here's the reagent, and it's basically two chemicals in a plastic tube. You break both of these internal containers, mix it, squeeze the resulting liquid up into the swab, and then apply it to the surface for 30 seconds. If it turns red, it contains lead. If it doesn't, it doesn't. It's as simple as that. So, we'll break this one, and we'll break this one. And we mix these chemicals together, as you can see. And we squeeze this up to the tip and saturate the swab. And we apply it. There we go. And you can see the liquid on there. We apply this for 30 seconds. As I said, if it contains lead, it turns red. If it doesn't, it doesn't. And it's as simple as that. Okay, 15 seconds. Make sure that's good and saturated, and it is. And I'll give it an extra 5 seconds here. All right, we've completed the test, and as you can see, there is not a hint of red on this swab anywhere, which means there is no lead content at all in this black wax recording blank. It has no lead in it at all. Zero. None. Nothing. So, we can test the swarf itself. And I'll apply this for 30 seconds. Lots of liquid coming out. Ten seconds to go, and this is the swarf. So if it's not detecting lead in swarf, there is no lead content in the cylinders whatsoever. All right, and as you see, not a hint of red, not even pink. So there is no lead content at all in a black wax recording blank. So I don't know where this information came from, but Like I said, I work with these blanks every day, so I wanted to make sure. The testing laboratory said this is the same test they would do if I paid them to do it, so it just seemed like this was a logical way to proceed. And as you saw for yourself, it has no lead content at all. This is basically the same formulation as brown wax, except the fact they've made it black. So, just wanted to do a quick test so you could see for yourself and eliminate any fear that this was in some way hazardous to your health, shaving these blanks. They contain no lead at all, zero. There is no molecular lead in them of any kind. The test, as you just saw, was completely zero. There is no lead content in black wax dictation cylinders. So I just wanted to do a quick video so you can see this for yourself. Do the test for yourself. You will find there is no lead content in black wax EDIPHONE cylinders. So as always, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. Answer all my emails, try to answer today, I get it. But again, I just want to prove that there is no lead content in these black wax recording blanks at all. So no hazard with using them, shaving them, recording on them. Again, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.